sorry, baby. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Hospital.
It's okay.
Ah!
I'm sorry.
My wrist.
I'm sorry.
Ah!
Eddie is not helping matters. Look, chica, you have to embrace it. Embrace your past and let it slide. You know you are married to an African man and it's within their nature to have children.
I am the one
who is traumatized here. Eddie needs to get that fact clear.
Let me get something right here. Are you trying to say that you are not going to have children or what?
I didn't say that, did I?
What are you saying?
I am saying that Eddie should give me some time. I need time to process. Listen, this whole thing is beginning to piss me off. I need time to process all of this.
Why not have a one-on-one discussion with him?
You think I haven't done that? I have done that countlessly. I have spoken to him softly, spoken to him harshly, cried, pleaded, begged, and he is still not listening.
The young man is probably tired.
Tired, you say? Tired of what exactly? Hold on a second, let me ask you, on whose side exactly are you? Are you on my side or on Eddie's side? Because what is this?
Listen, girlfriend, you know how I've been traumatized since I lost my pregnancy. You know how hard I've been trying to work on myself to heal. I am not emotionally ready for all of this.
It's okay. I didn't mean it. I didn't mean it this way. Please, I didn't mean it this way at all. I totally understand you, okay? All I'm trying to say is you don't have to be selfish with the decision, okay? Don't be selfish with it. Just, okay, don't worry. I'll talk to Eddie, okay?
That's what you should do. And not sit here to tell me when to get pregnant and when not to get pregnant.
I wasn't trying to do that, please.
It's okay, take this. Drink, Joy, it's too. Alright, what are we trying to do? So you know, to better understand it.
What would you like to eat? Let me get it ready for you.
Wait, you mean there's no food in the kitchen yet?
Like a chef. Mayosh, in fact, go and find food yourself.
Oh, dear Joel.
Why is it so hard for you to understand me? I cannot stand the thought of being pregnant right now. I'm not ready to carry a child.
Marriage is for procreation. Or is there a part of it I don't understand?
I can understand that you had a miscarriage in our first year of being married. But I mean, it's over 5 years and you're yet to overcome whatever fear and phobias you have. Come on, I want a child. That's not what we planned.
Eddie, I am trying. I am trying and God knows that. But I just cannot succumb this fear. There's this fear that engulfs me at the sound of the word pregnancy. I feel chills on my body. I have goosebumps everywhere. I am afraid, Eddie.
You know what? I used to think you were smart. But no, now I'm wrong.
But I am trying. Lord knows I am.
Into the office.
Yes, I'm aware of that. I'm actually here to see you, Eddie.
Then I guess she probably came talking to you.
I spoke with Chika earlier and I saw pain. I saw anguish. And I saw this fear, deep fear in her eyes. All I'm asking is for you to reduce your demand for a baby from her. For now, please. Let her heal.
Rosie, for crying out loud, for how long? For how long am I going to just keep hoping and wishes that she just turns around? from the very first year of our marriage. That's when this whole thing happened. And this is the fifth year. Because this is the fifth year and there's nothing to prove that we are married. There's no child. I'm just asking for one. Is that too much?
Eddie, I do understand you.
How would you even understand? How would you understand when you have three kids? So you probably don't know how empty I feel every time I come back home. Everywhere is just so quiet and no crowd of baby or babies perhaps.
Eddie, like I said before, I truly do understand you. I really do understand you, Eddie. Just that I don't understand where this sudden tocophobia is coming from. I know Chika is a very strong lady. So this is the reason I really want you to understand with her from there for now.
That's okay. But just know that my demand still stands, so you need to go and talk to her.
I will. I'm just saying, be patient for now like you have always been, please. All right?
Great.
You know I'm not going to stop you from drinking, right?
You don't understand, and I don't expect you to understand. Because look at you. You've got a lovely home with a beautiful wife and kids. Aren't you fulfilled? Aren't you happy?
Look,
it takes two to agree. If your wife is insisting she doesn't want to get pregnant, there's a reason for that. You should just let her be.
What are you insinuating? What are you even saying? Does she have a choice? Come on. I've tried my best. I've done everything for my wife to smile again. But she still finds it difficult. Do I have to pass through all this stress for my wife to get pregnant? Come on. The part that amazes me is the fact that we are okay medically.
Well, she's not. She needs time.
Can you recall what happened when she had a miscarriage? She nearly committed suicide.
Yo, come on, it's been 5 years. It's been 5 years. Isn't it about time she lets go of that phobia? Let's start making babies. You wouldn't even understand because, I mean, look at you.
Look, Eddie. I think you should just go home and take care of this issue. Handle this thing like a man, okay? Drinking is not going to help you get anywhere. If you like drink from now till tomorrow, the problem will still be there.
The real truth is there's no way I'm going back to that house. I'm telling you.
Well, I think you're going to have a problem because I don't have a spare room here for you.
Was there anywhere I was suggesting to come stay here? Who was even looking for your advice? I wasn't even expecting anything better because you're not even encouraging.
Look, all I'm saying is that you should just head home, give her time, take care of this issue. You got this, bro.
All right?
Got me worried.
Babe, listen, I hate the fact that we're always gonna have to fight over issues like this. You know, I hate it when we fight. I hate it because it really breaks me. And I'm truly sorry if I hurt you directly or indirectly. I don't know, but I'm sorry.
I'm sorry, too, for being unreasonable.
That's okay. Did I keep you waiting?
Yes. And that alcoholic smell?
Come on, babe. I went out with Leon and had a bottle or two. That's it.
And all my calls that you missed?
I'm sorry. Come here. I'm sorry, okay?
I miss you.
I miss you more. Babe, do not talk. I want to communicate with my boy.
Communicate what? Commute. What is wrong with you?
I'm trying to communicate with my boy.
Your boy? Are you serious right now? Listen, I can't wait for this child to come out so I can just rest.
Yeah, and I need to disappoint you, girl. When he comes out, I'll literally spend all the time with him.
Her.
Him.
Her.
It's him, baby.
Her.
Oh, God. Whatever.
Listen, I'm carrying a girl child.
Okay, whatever gender you are carrying, my love. I just know that I'll be the one to spend more time with them.
And you will be the one to breastfeed the baby as well.
Okay. Sure. Hey, buddy.
She's a girl.
A boy. Okay, that's fine. That's fine, baby. Come here. I love you.
I love you too.
Eddie. Honey. Honey. Oh. Eddie. Honey. Honey. Hospital.
Sorry. Sorry, baby. I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
Hospital.
It's okay.
My wrist.
I'm sorry.
Feel like I'm ripped away, 'cause never they feel the pains I've been through. I feel so scared to go down the lane again. Oh, I made up mind I can't take this again.
I know how you feel. You just have to remember that you have me by your side and embrace it.
Why? Eddie, why? You can't let this happen to me. I don't deserve this. God in heaven knows that I don't deserve this. Why would God let me have a miscarriage on the 6th month of my pregnancy? Why? Was I not careful enough?
It's okay, babe. It's a normal thing. You're not just the only one in this. Other people go through these kind of things too.
No. No, Eddie. There is nothing normal about a woman losing her child on the 6th month of her pregnancy. There is nothing normal about it. What?
I'm sorry, baby. I'm sorry.
No.
I'm sorry.
God hates me.
No, he doesn't. Trust me, another one is going to come and this time he or she will stay. I promise.
Feel like I'm ripped away. But never they feel the pains I've been through. I feel so scared to go down the lane again. I made up mind I can't take this again. Oh, everything will be alright. It's just a matter of time. We're in this together. It's gonna be over soon.
So, how exactly are you helping your wife? You know, it's just a result of internal fear that happened because of something. You have to be gentle with her.
Neil, what have I not done for my wife? You and I can testify that I am so nice to my wife. I'm literally the best husband on the planet. I'm not saying you're not going to your wife or something, but I mean, I've been so good that I care for her. I take her to vacations, but my wife is literally finding it difficult to get pregnant, and it's driving me insane. I'm tired.
Look, if you ask me, I think it's more of a psychological issue. She needs a therapist.
Yeah, I thought so too, and I've actually suggested that to her, but she still doesn't want to agree. She's just being so difficult. But listen, the truth is, I need a child.
I mean, Leo, I need a child. I am not getting any younger. I need to start making babies of my own. It's even in the Bible, go to the world and multiply. I mean.
Anyways, I still think you should be gentle with her. You know, just keep loving her like you've always done. You know, things will change.
I still love her and I will always do, but I just hope the change comes so soon.
Yeah, it's you, bro. It's you.
Can I have more drinks, man? Because, I mean, there's literally nothing here.
More drinks? Bro, you've emptied my bar. Literally. Like, it's the last drink in my bar.
Whatever, man. Whatever. I'm still gonna finish it, though. You will start by telling me what you are doing with contraceptives! You what? We had sex last night only for you to wake up in the morning to take pills. I don't even understand. Is it that you don't want this child as much as I do?
I do. I really do, but I cannot find myself carrying a child right now. I do not have the guarantee whether the child is going to survive or not.
Oh, cut that crap! Tell me if the world or perhaps if your parents had gone this lane of yours, you probably wouldn't have been alive today.
I am not my parent. You need to understand what I'm saying.
What, Chica? Understand the fact that you don't want to get pregnant? Understand the fact that you don't want me to be a father? Come on. Listen, I don't want to even act like or probably compare you to my friends or say friends of mine who we got married at the same time have kids and their parents now. No, but I mean, I want one. Just want a child. So the world will know that I'm also married.
Are you married? To me, or to the world.
Oh, there she goes again. Quit this emotional blackmail. I am married to you, but I want to be your father.
I cannot do this with you. I cannot do this.
Oh, look at what is going on. Why is it so difficult for you to...
He came to you?
Who else will he go to? Your mother? Look, Chika. Eddie has endured enough. But taking contraceptives just so you can avoid being pregnant is extreme.
I am not ready to have children. And whatever it takes for me to avoid that is what I will do.
Aren't you a married woman? Are you supposed to be running away from being pregnant? Oh, is it because you are married to a good man?
What exactly is your opinion about me? You think I'm some witch or something, or I do not want children of my own? Of course I do. I want my own children. I want a child, somebody to call me mother. But each time I try, my heart keeps failing me. I need time to process this.
Eddie is a good man, because not all men will keep calm and watch their wife make such drastic decisions. You just have to try and get pregnant, please. Even God is angry at you.
I need time to heal. Do you think I'm happy the way things are? I'm not.
Okay. Why don't you see a therapist?
Listen, don't be like that. I didn't say I'm mad. I'm not mad. I'm just saying I need time to heal. Why would you ask me to go?
That's the only way for you to help yourself, please.
You know I'm not going to stop you from drinking, right? Vent your anger. Let it all out. You'll feel better at the end of the day.
You know how much I want a child. Why would she do what she did? Why would she do that?
My wife took contraceptives during our first year of marriage. I told you about that, right?
That's first year, not 5 years.
Look. I still think you should give her some time. She will come around.
That's my problem. You don't understand.
I've given her 5 years, isn't that? Come on, is 5 years not enough for someone to have overcome her worries and frights?
Look, I understand, but you just have to take it easy. This drink is not going to help you in any way.
I wasn't even expecting you to understand, because you're not me.
You see, Ellie, like I told you, this new marriage stuff that has been overwhelming you. I love my wife this, I love my wife that. I told you that one day all this thing will end. My brother, marriage is a trap. If you don't go forward, you don't go backward. You're just stuck in the middle, like you're stagnant.
I don't even know what you're saying, because like my wife still worships me like every day. So, but the only thing is, I just need the company to send me on a trip.
Eddie, you and I know you don't like going for trips. You and I know that for sure. So let's tell ourselves the truth.
The atmosphere in my home is no longer encouraging. My wife is making it difficult for me. She's finding it difficult to get pregnant. It's been 5 years.
My guy, you know me. Come on, you know me very well. I'm not a man of love. So let me tell you something. If I were in your shoes, I would have longed sick for a divorce. Yes. If she's not ready to get pregnant, then just divorce her and get another wife. Come on, what is she doing in your house if she can't get pregnant? Come on now, guy. Yeah. Be a man.
Look at the way I'm just looking at you. Do you truly love your wife?
Of course I love my wife, Eddie. You know I love my wife, but that doesn't mean she should be stupid. Come on, if she's not ready to give you children, man, divorce her and get another wife. It's as simple as anything. Okay?
I think I just made a stupid mistake by even coming to you and discuss my worries with you. Because you just give me a stupid...
Hey, this is a good advice, not a stupid advice, okay? Just divorce her and get another wife. It's simple.
I'll see you later, man. I need to get back to work.
You can too. Are you leaving? See, I can even get married to like 5 wives, like one in the UK, one in the US, anywhere. Man, I give birth to plenty children everywhere. See this one. Your wife is not ready to give birth. You're here saying rubbish. No, you're not ready for life, bro. Seriously, you're not. Where's my pen?
I really want a child. I do. If only Eddie can see how much I yearn to be called a mother. I just can't stand the process. How do I go through all of this only to end up losing the baby? Oh God, please heal me.
The days I had the most, trying to conquer the fear. Can't believe the past 2 days, oh. The day hurts the most, feel like I'm ripped
Eddie.
Away.
Cause nobody feels I'm sorry.
I have nothing against you. But I just want you to see things from my own point of view.
I made up mind, I can't take these again. I want babies too. I do. I want children to call me mommy. Just that I'm afraid. I am so afraid that after going through this whole process of conception, I will end up losing the pregnancy.
But babe, I told you your mother's gonna be there for you, didn't I?
Yes, I agree. I will see the therapist.
Why the sudden change? I mean, it's something you never wanted.
The fact that this makes you constantly angry and unhappy breaks my heart even more. I just need help so I can get my husband back.
Come here.
Man, I've got a whole lot going through my mind right now. And whenever I feel this way, going to the office is not an option for me.
Yeah, I understand, bro. It rains everywhere.
Yeah, I know. Chica has finally agreed to see a therapist.
Are you serious? Why the sudden change of heart?
I don't know. Probably the childlessness is beginning to bother her too.
Interesting. Exactly what you always wanted, right?
Exactly. I mean, with a therapy by her size, she could probably change her mind and decide to get pregnant.
Yeah. Let's stay positive, right?
Yeah, right. Cheers.
So about, you know, I wanted to ask you about the contract that we were actually talking about sometime.
Seriously, right now, I don't want to discuss work. I just want to...
Hey, babe.
You're ready to leave already?
Yes.
I see. When are we seeing the therapist?
Babe, I told you to calm down. I'll get you the best of the therapist around town.
Babe, I need to see a therapist. And quickly, too.
Babe, I said calm down. Just calm your nerves. Okay? I got this.
Are you sure?
I got this.
I need to see a therapist.
I'll get you a therapist. See you later.
You have a nice day.
Yeah, you can say
that. But I need to see a therapist. Your husband reported you to me, and I don't find that interesting.
Wait, my husband reported me to you?
Okay, now you're laughing because I'm not suited up and seated on my office desk, yeah?
I have told him to use all this his energy and set a new record in World Guinness Book. I've told him that.
Then he's going to be a very big and popular celebrity.
Who cares? By then I'll be divorced.
Don't be like that now.
For bringing our bedroom matters to you, I'm going to punish him. I will not let him touch me for a whole month.
Come on, girl. Don't do that to that young man.
You think
man.
I can't do it?
I'm not saying you can't do it. I'm just saying you shouldn't do that. Listen, you can't try that with Eddie. You don't let Eddie touch you for 1 month, this roof will come down. Don't do that thing.
You know, I'm just kidding.
Good for you.
Okay, so have you seen the therapist yet?
No. Eddie has been quite busy in the past couple of weeks. I am still waiting for him. But one thing he doesn't know is that the longer I wait, the more I change my mind.
Wait, are you threatening us?
I can threaten you guys for all I care. I mean, now that I'm ready to see a therapist, y'all get me a therapist.
Relax, just take a chill pill. I knew you were going to come around.
Don't be too sure. I just may change my mind and not want to see anybody. Now back to your bedroom matters.
No, I'm not going there.
You are going.
Hey.
How did it go?
She's starting tomorrow.
You are just telling me? And is a she?
Yeah, we literally had no time, so I booked 3 sections for you in a week. And yes, is a she.
women understanding women. Do you have a problem with that?
Not exactly. I just find it awkward that you were just telling me. I feel like if I didn't ask you, you wouldn't have told me.
I was still going to tell you. I mean, you said you needed a therapist. I got you one now, baby. Why are you still complaining?
Come on, what exactly do you want?
To see a therapist. Good. Can I breathe now?
Yes, you can. And I mean, I need to break too. Come on.
About this, your talking office.
Nigga, it's your company office. You're talking about that.
Man, see, can you do me a favor? I need you to cover up for me for a few days.
Where are you going to?
It's my wife.
So you're still in this your wife stuff. Come on now.
That's with fast. The real truth is, I booked up a therapy session and the therapist is saying that I need to be with her every time the session is going on.
Okay. Therapy is nice, you know, at least to make her stop all this.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, now that she has agreed to go, I need to be there for her.
Fine, I got you, man.
Thanks, man. Thanks, my lady. Thanks, bro. So, what's popping now?
Yeah, I got drink. Let me give you this.
Okay. Hold on, this is exactly what I would need right now.
You know I got you.
Yeah. No ice.
It's good to have you in our home, madam.
And if there's anything you want, do not hesitate to tell us.
Thank you so much. I appreciate your kind gesture. Thank you. Okay, so let's get started.
So how many years have you been married?
5 years.
Any miscarriage? Any loss of baby?
What is wrong?
Have I been that bad?
Listen, I don't want to make you feel worse than you have, but the real truth is, therapists, that's how they behave. They're just blunt in nature. They can't help it because that's part of what they do.
I'm sorry.
Chika, please don't, do not start this now. Like, I mean, you know, I don't like seeing you in this mood.
Do you know she said a lot of unpleasant and terrible things? I mean, the way she wasn't sounding nice at all.
Were you expecting her to be mild with you? She's just doing her job.
Girl, now I know that I have been the problem.
Oh, wait. You didn't know before now that you've been the problem?
Listen, Angie, I know. Alright? I know that I am a bag full of troubles, but girl, it's not as terrible as she painted it. Do you know she even said that Eddie would have married another wife if he wasn't a good man? What kind of nonsense is that?
I don't know that. Is it because God gave you a good husband? You're here thinking maybe all men are like him.
Anyways, I think she's doing a very good job, but the only way I'll know she's doing a good job is
if she's able to convince you to get pregnant. Then I'll give her flowers.
Well, I need already. Alright, okay.
Please, I am famished. Do you have any food at home?
I made pasta. What protein would you like it to be served with?
So what do you have right now? Because I cannot wait. Give me what you have now.
That's okay. I got you.
In her head, she wants to get pregnant, but there's still this fear inside her.
And that's why we're having this meeting. I mean, since we already know that she is scared, like there's this fear, then you should cast it away.
She has to stay around someone who is pregnant. I mean, staying around someone who is carrying what she's afraid of carrying, it will motivate her.
So is there no other way?
I don't think so.
You said you guys have gone for different vacations and done a lot of stuff together, and yet she's still afraid. That's just the only way.
So, but how are we, where are we going to find this pregnant human that she will just, you know, get used to and probably get over her fears? Where are we going to get that from?
You have to act pregnant.
I don't understand. What does that even mean?
You have to act pregnant. When she sees herself inside of you, I think she'll be more motivated. She'll want to. You're about the closest person for now, so.
Are you sure this is gonna work?
Trust me, it will work. In fact, it has worked already for me.
There's no way I'm going to do that.
Who is going to do it?
I don't know. Probably we'll just go out there, look for somebody who is pregnant, and then bring it back to the house.
Eddie, you mean you want us to let a total stranger into our home? Really? Is that what you want?
That's... What do you want me to do then? I can't even act to be pregnant.
Fine. I think at this point, we are on the same page. I cannot be pregnant.
This is quite a punishment.
No, it wasn't my suggestion.
You know, right?
Come on, it was the therapist that suggested it. The therapist even said, until further notice. I was the one who, you know, out of compassion, just said 2 weeks. Isn't he lucky I didn't make it 1 month?
Better. Because I'm not about supporting you for now.
Yeah, I can decide to make it 1 month or 6. I mean, after all, the therapist said, till further notice. I am tired of you already. I'm driving, girl. You need to get out of my car. Safety rules, no calls while driving. I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Hey, Eddie.
Angie, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you?
I'm okay.
What are you doing here?
I came to pick up something from one of the stores, but I'm not sure which one, so I need to check it out myself.
Oh, okay.
And what are you doing here?
I came to pick a few things for my babies.
Oh, toys and kids. Okay, yes, okay, okay. Yes. That's amazing. Okay, so...
Eddie.
Yeah.
I've been meaning to see you. My plan was to like fix a date and then come to your office and see you.
But you know you can always come by the house or my office. I'm really not a very busy person.
Yeah, that's true. Anyways, it's no longer news that you want a baby for my friend. But I think it's time you pay your own price. I already know what is happening. My friend briefed me. So I really want to encourage you to please carry out the exercise. I believe it will encourage my friend to get pregnant. Please.
Oh, I've thought of it, but I mean, I don't have any other choice, do I?
What? You're going to do it?
Mm-hmm.
My friend is going to be the happiest when I tell her this.
Okay, so I don't think you know your friend very well because she's a very stubborn creature.
Wait. Are you insulting my friend in front of me?
No, come on now. But that's okay. Anyways, I need to hurry so I can pick up and get back to the office.
All right. Me too, I need to run home.
All right, take care of yourself.
All right, take care.
Safe, yeah?
Yeah, bye.
Oh, don't you dare give me that attitude. What is that? Why are you being so selfish?
How am I being so selfish? No, tell me, why is it so hard for you to get pregnant just like every other woman does?
The same way it is hard for you to act as though you are pregnant.
Oh, there she goes.
You see, you see, you see? It's just a simple task. And you are making a mountain out of no hill.
You know, my problem is not even the acting. How about I go ahead and act and afterwards you don't get pregnant?
I will. I mean, why would I want to go back on my word? Just act as though you're pregnant and then by the time you're done, I will take... Listen, take for instance, there's a fence here. I'm trying to jump a fence in this living room and then you come and you aid me to jump the fence. You know, it's called support.
Support? I'll support you. I mean, it's easy. I'm in.
Good. So if it is that easy, why don't you do it? When you're done, I take him.
I mean, it's not even difficult.
Then do it.
Okay, I will do it. I mean, for how long is it going to last for?
2 weeks. Just 2 weeks.
Okay, 2 weeks. I'm in. I'll do it. But just get pregnant at the end of my 2 weeks. I've got a call.
Yeah, hello. Ah, yeah, exactly. So I was thinking.
Come on, Dad. Knock before you enter my office. Come on.
Knock because I'm entering as a rock.
Nigga, this is my office, not yours, okay?
Whatever, man.
See, you do. I want you to cover up for me. I just want to leave the office for a few days.
I don't understand. What do you mean cover up for you? You just left not too long ago and you want to leave again.
It's about what I told you over the phone.
Guy, don't tell me you really want to do this.
It's funny to you. I mean, that's the only way my wife will agree to get pregnant.
Man, this is hilarious. I don't think I've heard of this before in my life.
And now you're just hearing it. Well, okay, well.
You know, I got you 100%.
You got me?
Yeah, sure, I do.
Thanks, bro. Thanks, bro.
You're welcome, pregnant man.
I don't blame you.
Pregnant man. And don't forget to knock next time when you come into my office.
Pregnant man.
Understand is why you are still sleeping. Eddie, wake up!
What is it now? Is the house on fire?
Yes, the house is on fire because if the house is not on fire, why will you be sleeping? Why are you sleeping by this time when you're supposed to be in the kitchen?
Cook?
Sweep! Are we not going to eat? Or are we fasting?
Yeah, I can't go to the kitchen. Can't you say I'm pregnant?
Oh, wow. You are pregnant. Oh, so because you are pregnant, we are going to starve to death, right? Huh? That's okay. Now I know that pregnant women are very lazy. So Chika isn't getting pregnant.
Not fair now. That's not fair now. You should not be doing this now. Okay, I'll go and do it.
Why? But why do you have to do that? I mean, can't you see that you are pregnant? You don't have to do a thing. Just relax. Relax, okay? Where are you going to? Oh my God, who is doing this to him? Are you having cravings? No, come and sleep. You think I'll be the one to go to the kitchen and cook? Okay.
What are you trying to do?
I'm trying to sit up, girl.
Do you have to do it in a very lazy manner? Have you finished doing the dishes?
Yes, babe. I've been done with it long ago. But besides, that's not part of the game. I'm beginning to do too much.
So tell me, what was part of the game? Listen, these are things that I will have to do eventually when I get pregnant. So you have to do them and do them well and stop acting like it's such a big deal because it's not. I mean, except you don't want me to.
Okay, baby, I will. Okay.
Meanwhile, I want to eat yam, softly boiled yam, and egg sauce later in the day. So get that ready. Is that clear?
Okay.
Good. Don't make it too... What are you trying to do?
Let's just say I'm pregnant. I'm craving for it.
Yo.
The baby is craving for granola.
The baby?
Yes.
It's not only crave, it's craver.
What is it now?
I thought you dusted this place.
But you're here, you saw me doing it now.
You dusted this place, yet it looks like someone just emptied a bag of cement on it. You better go get a rag and dust this place properly.
But I'm tired now.
You're tired what? Instead of you to clean this place, you were busy dusting me. Do I look like trash?
Baby, I'm tired.
Like you don't even want me to go on this pregnancy journey, so no problem, it's better for me, I'll rest.
Do it now.
No, don't do it. Don't do it, Eddie. Yeah? Please don't do it. Eddie, where are you now?
I'm coming. I'm looking for the rag. I'm coming.
Ew! You need to hurry. This place is irritating. Massage my feet or you want to hurt me?
Sorry.
Hello? What's going on?
bad.
That's why you want to twist my ankle? I asked for a massage. A simple massage that a spouse should be able to give another. Why is it such a big deal? Please massage my feet. I'm still feeling pains on my ankle.
No,
you see? You're tired. That's the same way I'm tired of getting pregnant.
It's
okay.
What are you saying? What are we even talking about? Listen, by the time Eddie has finished this 2 weeks course, he will know exactly what women go through when they are pregnant. He will no longer say as simple as ABC. He will understand.
Don't you think you are being too harsh on him?
What are you saying? When I become pregnant, who's going to help me with the chores? Is it not the one? And other things around the house. So he should play his card well.
It's just too funny what you both are doing. I won't
lie. Listen, anything to get Chika pregnant is not too much. I gotta go, girl. I gotta go. Leave me and Eddie alone. We're gonna be okay.
One second. What?
What's going on?
What do you mean, what's going on?
What is that?
Hey, bring down your voice. My wife is around.
Are you alright?
Sure, I'll explain. Listen, do not raise your voice. Take your voice down. My wife is in there.
What's going on? Why did you tell me this big?
Okay, I'm acting to be pregnant. In that way, Chika can get pregnant.
What?
Yeah.
It's like the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Honestly, anybody would think it is. I mean, you could laugh over it too. But I mean, sometimes I keep wondering, is this what every husband does for their wives to get pregnant? Or why do mine have to get to this extreme? Look at me. Do not laugh at me. Do not.
My brother, if you ask me, I would say you should, carry your cross and embrace it. You know, we all have where it pinches us. You understand?
Whatever, I'm already doing it. I mean, since that's what she wants. Oh, do not laugh. I'm serious.
Sorry.
Do not.
I'm sorry, I just can't help you. You look like a clown. Like, what the hell is going
on? Leo, I said do not laugh.
Okay, I'm sorry. You know, you and your wife, you guys need to be in a reality show or something. Are you kidding me?
You can say that again, because, I mean, who wouldn't think this is some reality? This is what she wants. So if this could get her pregnant, I would do anything for her.
But why didn't you tell me about this?
Because it would sound awkward. And I felt it wasn't even necessary.
It is awkward, bro. I'll tell you that much.
Come on, let's get inside.
Yeah.
Listen, no laughing. Comport yourself.
Okay. I got you, bro. I'm sorry.
No laughing.
I'm sorry, man. No laughing. No laughing.
No laughing.
Yeah.
I said no laughing.
Yeah, no, I'm not laughing. I'm not.
Watch yourself. I'm serious.
I'm sorry. You look like a clown.
Listen, if you don't comport yourself, you're going to have to leave my house. I'm serious.
Okay. All right, I'm sorry. Sorry, it's what happened today.
Leave my house.
Wait. It's what happened.
My wife is in the house. I'm trying so hard not to make her feel, discomfortable and all of that kind of thing.
Please. Sorry again, I'm sorry. But how far gone are you? What's in there?
She's gonna be for some few weeks, probably two, and then she's gonna agree to get pregnant. Stop laughing, please.
Oh no, you have to leave my house. You have to leave my house.
This is mine, bro. You're pregnant. You're supposed to be drinking. Thank you.
Like seriously, Eddie? Are you just going to sit there and not lift a finger to help me?
I thought you were not gonna ask.
You thought? Thought. You're not going to help? Are you being serious? Are you being serious right now? Were you not getting up to come and assist me wear this? Eddie, am I not talking to you? Okay, it's very obvious that you're not ready for me to get pregnant.
I'm coming.
No, don't come. Allow me beg for everything. It's everything I beg for in this house. Necklace that other people's husbands will just help them and wear. If it's you that is wearing your necklace now, I'll come and stand behind you. I'll be petting you and be wearing the necklace on you.
Bring it, Jerry. Let me help you.
You should run sometimes, not just stretches. It's good for the baby.
Is that one even necessary?
When I was pregnant, did you not hear when the doctor used to say to me? Huh? It's good for your pelvic floor.
What?
Listen, you need to see how funny you look in this. You know those comedians when we go for marriages that comes out with pot belly, big bum bum packed up with clothes? That is exactly how you look. Why do you look so funny in this?
Me, I'm tired.
Sorry.
Me, I'm having cravings. No, the baby is having cravings.
Cravings already?
I notice anytime I do this exercise, that is when the cravings increases.
So what is the baby craving?
We're craving.
No, dance. You don't want to dance anymore? You don't want to dance anymore? So this is what you do when I leave the house. You take off the pregnancy, relax, and have some fun. This is what you do, yet you've been pestering me to get pregnant, Eddie.
Babe, come on. I just wanted to rest a little bit.
Oh, you wanted to rest. Rest from the farm work that you went to, or rest from the mountain that you climbed, or rest from what exactly? You cannot even act being pregnant for 2 weeks, Eddie. Yet you want me to carry a big baby bump and walk around. When I get pregnant, will I rest? Until 9 months is over, will I rest even more? Because I mean, the time to get pregnant and then the breastfeeding period, will I rest? Looks like you don't even want me to go on this pregnancy journey. So it's okay, excuse me.
Come on! It's almost you, so I just get it sometimes.
Listen, let me tell you something. For this simple act that you have done, it is no longer 2 weeks. One extra week,
nope.
That is your punishment.
Babe, come on now. This is not fair now. Babe, this is not fair. What? What's this now?
Why are you dragging your feet on the floor? Walk like a human being. And please close some of your legs. Haba. I thought it was easy, actually.
What are you watching, please?
I'm watching this movie. It's a new one. Eddie, please, can you get me that glass of wine?
Wine is closer to you. You can take it.
Eddie, can you get me the glass of wine?
It's closer to you.
But I want you to get it for me.
Oh, God.
Is that not the same way you asked me to do things for you? Do I complain? Okay, now it's my turn. It's a big deal for you to pick an ordinary glass of wine for me.
But it's closer to you.
Eddie, pick the glass of wine for... Don't worry. Let's see who gets pregnant.
Okay.
Are you squeezing your face? Is it me you're squeezing your face to
I'm
give me wine?
I'm not squeezing my face. I'm just giving you the wine.
So now, keep your face properly and give me the wine.
Take now.
I'll not drink wine that you're not smiling to give me. I don't want something that will choke me.
Okay, I'll smile.
Thank you. Oh, my hands can't get there. Please help me drop it.
Your hands are...
Eddie, open. Please help me drop it now. Stop whining. There. Do you know that this guy that is wearing this blue shirt there? It's just like you. Likes whining.
I would like to do the extra 1 week.
For all the times that you, Eddie, have faltered in this game. For all the times that you have enjoyed yourself, taken out your bomb, and made me look stupid. Yes, you will.
Oh no,
that's
not fair. If
you talk some more, I will make it 2 extra weeks. Please take a glass to the kitchen. Thank you. No, thank you. This guy is so funny. Look here. Who has time for? Who has time for you? Eddie! Eddie, can I have water, please? Eddie! Eddie! Can I have a glass of water? Cold water with ice in it. Eddie? I asked for food. Are you going to let me starve to death? Huh. Eddie!
Yeah, I'm right here. I made you your favorite. Your favorite jollof rice.
Oh, no. Bring it here. I want to eat in the bed. Just set the food here.
Here you go.
Open it.
Ta-da! Food is ready.
Why are you so excited when I haven't even tasted the meal?
Because you will know that your husband is the best chef on the planet. I mean, with Hyodabachi and White Money put together, I am still better.
Why don't you let my test board do the judgment? Looks good though. Ew! Ow!
What is it?
What is this? Pepe! Do you want to kill me or something?
How?
Taste it! You see?
Does it taste good to you?
But there was no pepper at the time I made the rice.
And then you finally decided to use all the pepper in the kitchen and put in it so that it can kill me.
I'm sorry.
It is just jollof rice. Just jollof rice.
Okay, that's fine. I'll fix something else.
Excuse me. It's just jollof rice, Eddie. You know what? Thank you. I'll just eat out.
When I was putting the jollof rice, there was no pepper now. What happened to me? Let me taste the chicken. Let me get the chicken. The chicken is fine. I'm sure everything chicken now. This one is also good. There's no pepper in this one.
By the time I am done with him, he will know that it's not easy. Chika, why are you being so hard on him? And that's not fair.
Did you say it's not fair?
My darling, it is. Listen, right now, I am the man. So I'm going to enjoy all my immunities and act like one.
Wait, is that why you gave him extra 1 week?
He told you that too.
He called me on phone.
As his what exactly? Mother or a caregiver?
Babe, please, have compassion on that young man, please.
He is lucky I didn't make it 2 extra weeks. Do you know that whenever I leave this house, Eddie takes off the pump, enjoys himself, drinks, dances, plays. I mean, like, enjoy. He's going to serve his punishment.
I don't understand. Were you expecting him to carry it everywhere he goes to?
Now, let me ask you a question. When I get pregnant, will I be choosing the days to stay with my bump and the days to get off the bump?
Huh? That is quite different.
Girl? Ain't nothing different about that. There's nothing different about it. Eddie has to serve his punishment.
Chika, please now. Allow this poor guy to breathe.
He's not breathing,
please,
girl.
Please, do not suffocate him.
He is not breathing. There ain't no breathing for Eddie.
I think this is too much, baby. Relax. Oh, God.
Are you just going to lay there and watch me or lift a finger to help? Eddie!
Oh, I'm tired now.
Me, oh. Why would you even be sleeping in the first place when I'm cleaning?
Because my hormonal imbalances are, you know, giving me reasons.
It's a lie. Nothing like hormonal imbalance. How can hormonal imbalance make you so comfortable in pregnancy? Eddie, stand up and help me. Mm-hmm. Eddie! Okay, no problem. Be very comfortable. Rest very well so that you have all the energy to carry the real pregnancy.
Now, what is this? Okay, what do you want me to do now?
Massage my palm. It's paining me. You want me to fall?
Sorry.
Eddie, if you break my finger, I'm not going to carry any pregnancy.
I'm sorry now.
Do it softly. Are you hissing at me?
No.
Next one.
You just have to pardon me, bro. I can't just help each time I see you like this.
Listen, it's not your fault.
Sorry.
For
But you told me about the phone she went out. How come you're still wearing this stuff?
Because Leo, you won't believe it. The last time I tried to remove it, I packed an extra 1 week and it's not funny. Why are you laughing?
Sorry, bro. It's the back for me. You guys are something else. What?
And honestly, I am freaking tired already.
Yeah, I understand how you feel, but look, you signed up for this. We just have to deal with it, alright?
Oh, God. I just hope I'm not doing this for nothing.
Nah, look. I don't think she let you go through all this and not get pregnant at the end of the day. I don't think so.
Oh, Leo, you don't know my wife. She's so unpredictable. The next minute you guys have an agreement, she'll feel cool, and then the next second, boom, she does otherwise.
No, God no go agree, I beg. God no go agree.
Amen. Man, but let me tell you the real truth. Forget the fact that I'm acting to be pregnant. It's tiring. These genders go through a whole lot. I mean, they deserve a bunch of flour, boxes of chocolates on daily, bro.
Bro, you need to cut us some slack too. Women are trying.
Yeah, I know. But man. Anyways, let's leave this aside. How's work going, bro?
Yeah, work is good, but I don't need to ask you because you now, you're a full-time housewife.
Listen, do not start what you can't finish. Do not start up a fight with me, I'm telling you. What's that for?
See your head. I don't blame you, man. I just want my wife to be pregnant. I want to have kids.
How do you even move around? I don't see you walking here.
It's crazy. You don't want to see. You need to see shit I do right out here where she's around. What? I'm cleaning her hands.
To go to the office and see what's going on.
No, you can't.
That's not fair.
Call them on the phone.
Well, you know, it doesn't work like that. I need to be there in person.
On one condition.
Why?
That you go there with your baby bump.
Chica, is that a joke or what?
Let me take a guess. Maybe I am the new comedian in town. Yeah. Yes, I suppose. Now, when I get pregnant, am I going to be hiding in this house with the baby bump? I will go literally everywhere with my bump. So if you are acting pregnant, then you need to go everywhere with your bump, including your office.
Well, that's not right. That's not right. How can I go to my office with this? They'll probably think I'm crazy or something.
You know, one thing that I do not appreciate when I am reading set is noise. So I will just let you have this space.
So my guy, are you not done with this, your acting stuff?
When I back the next 1 week to continue acting.
Seriously, your wife is really serious about this.
And the truth is, she's just doing it to frustrate me.
Nigga, I feel your wife is using you to watch real life comedy. And I think I need to be in your house at this point. At least let me ease off my stress.
Serious. You're not serious. You just play with everything. Anyways, did anything happen in my absence at work?
No, not at all.
Okay.
Aside the misconduct from the intense guy. Well, I sent you an email.
Oh, okay, it's nothing. I mean, since the ND didn't complain, who am I? Besides, the boy is still going through his learning process.
Man, I don't think I like that. In fact, I don't like that guy. I don't.
Come on, stop hitting on people, man. The boy is just a small boy.
I say I don't like the guy now. Are you forcing me to like the guy? I don't like him.
Eddie. Eddie has the guts to leave this house without his pregnancy. Okay. Let's see. And he won't even pick up my calls.
The guy is innocent, just allow him. Let's hold on a second, my friends. So, what's wrong with your wife calling you?
My wife? She didn't know I left. I left just when she left the house. And now I think she's back.
Okay, what is wrong with you going out?
Don't you understand that I left the house without the belly? It's going to be another phase because I already got 1 week and now it's probably going to be 2 weeks.
Pregnant man, how can you go out without your pregnancy? How?
Oh God. You're not even helping matters.
Should I be here? See, if I were you, I would just stay calm till I leave, okay? Yes.
Pick my calls already! By explaining to me why you left the house without your pregnancy.
Come on, what do you expect? You would have expected me to go with a big belly and people probably think this guy's sick or something.
Really? Eddie, you accepted this game. So you will carry it with all the baggages that comes with it, including taking it to the shop, taking it to the church, and everywhere you go.
Are you serious?
I am serious.
No, this is not going to happen.
That will happen.
Are you for real? People, what do you expect people to say? That this dude is crazy because you want me to go with a bumpy belly?
That's it.
I'm sorry, I can't do that, trust me.
That's it? So people will think that I'm crazy when they eventually see me with a baby bump, right? So people will think I'm mad and that's what you want me to do. So you want me going on the streets and people thinking that I'm crazy? Eddie, you just scolded me. Really? Okay, listen up here. You will be the one to carry the 9 months pregnancy because Chika here will not go on the street and let people think that I am crazy.
Oh God, baby, come on.
Don't touch.
Okay, listen, I'll do it. You know, I'll never do anything to hurt you on purpose. I am truly sorry, but there remains that I couldn't have gone out with the baby bumpy belly. People will probably think I'm crazy. The bloggers will take it around town that there's this pregnant man. And that's your husband they'll be talking about. I mean, it doesn't make sense.
How can you say that baby bump don't make sense?
That's not what I said. I'm sorry, okay? Oh, come on, cheer up. Listen, I'm going to resume my wifely duties. Oh, is that what I said? Okay, yes, my pregnancy duties. I'll clean the house, mop the floor. No, probably mop your feet too, massage you. Come here. You'll be fine.
You're going to wind your waist 5 times clockwise and 5 times anti-clockwise. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Come on, Eddie. 5. Good. Now, anti-clockwise. 1. Let's go. 2. Don't let me count faster than you. 3. 4.
Yeah, I don't like it. I'm tired.
You're going to eat for the baby. What is this that you're doing? What is this that you're doing exactly? Eh? I said this, you wind your waist and you're acting like it. Wind your waist. Already. Let's go. Don't let me count faster than you. 1, 2. 3, 4. Eddie, you can do this. 1 more time, let's go. 5, good job. So now, because of your pelvic region, you're going to put your hand behind your head, open your legs, take your pelvis down, up, down, up, squat like that for 10 times. Let's go.
I'm having cravings already.
What do you mean by you're having cravings? You're having cravings for what exactly?
I'm having cravings. No, the baby. I'm trying to communicate. The baby wants ice cream
vanilla ice cream,
pineapple, apple,
shawarma. Yes.
As long as the baby is not having cravings for human beings, do your squat. Eddie, do your squat. You can do this. Come on, it's good for you.
After this one, me, I'll go inside and get my cravings. So.
Eddie, this is going to help your contractions. Come on, let's go.
Open your hands up like this. Good.
Open your legs properly. Put this dressing between your legs. Let me see if you're doing it right or not.
I can't do this.
Squat, just squat. Three. Good job. You can do this. Four. Eddie. Here you go. A glass of room temperature of wine. I am being a good husband, am I not?
This is not what the baby is craving for now.
After exercise, what you need is a glass of room temperature water. It's good for your baby.
If it does know what the baby was crying for, I already told you what we want.
Drink up.
Baby, come on. You know you can do this. You can. And of course, me doing this means you can actually do this.
Pregnancy is not as easy as you make it look. If it were this easy, I mean, who would have issues with it?
Of course it is.
It is because you are acting it. And by the time you start getting sick, feel ill, you know, vomit, nausea, malaria, typhoid, all of those irritating sicknesses that comes with it, you will understand that it's not actually easy.
Is that what you're scared of?
And then when you go through all of that, only to lose the child in the end.
Come on, baby, I can understand. But I want you to understand also that sickness is a normal thing. Everybody does go through sicknesses. But then when this sickness part of the pregnancy comes, just assume it's malaria and typhoid, and you get over it, and then for the pregnancy to last, we just leave it to God. Because it's never going to disappoint us.
Oh, well. Oh, well. Go take a shower before you start to ooze.
What are you saying? Like I smell?
I didn't say so, did I?
Okay, but you're going to make sure the shower is hot before I do that.
The heater is on, Eddie. Can you go run a bath now? Do you have waist pain too?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so sorry. Oh. Look at this one.
Last time I checked, I'm still the man of the house.
Oh. You say? Turn around, let me see you. Man of the house. Come on, come on. You are. Oh, interesting.
even see how you look in this.
Shh.
Hold on. Let me listen to the baby's heartbeat.
Talk to mommy, baby girl. You want me to eat some sandwiches for you? She wants me to eat some sandwiches for her.
I should add a shawarma.
Oh, my baby. I love you.
She says I should add a shawarma.
And daddy has to be the one to buy it. Come on, Eddie.
My husband. Thank you for doing this for me.
Are you finally accepting that I'm doing something for you?
Am I not appreciative?
You. Instead of you to appreciate things somebody will do for you, you want to take the credit.
Come on, Eddie. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Come on, come here. Kiss you. Are you not the man of the house? Come here. Thank you, baby.
I needed this.
You sounded so exhausted. Where did you go?
Yeah, my sister just put to bed.
Was she pregnant?
Yeah, I told you.
It completely eluded me. She would have been the perfect specimen.
The perfect what?
Never mind. So how's she?
She's fine. I've been the one running up and down trying to, you know, help them pick up clothes, you know, all the baby stuff, you know. I'm so tired.
Oh, poor man.
He has no clue. He doesn't even know what to do. He has just been running up and down. I had to just go and help them.
Big auntie's duties.
Yeah.
So what's the sex of their child?
Okay, it's a boy.
A boy? Yeah. Aw, that's so good to hear.
Thank you.
Did she have any sort of complications, tearing, you know, all those kind of issues during childbirth?
Chika, she did not have any form of complication. As a matter of fact, she had a very smooth pregnancy.
I know where you are going with this.
Really?
I know.
Eh? You are trying to put fear in your mind. Now that's what you are trying to do. You have to fight this fear. You have to let it go so that you can, you know.
Listen, I will think about it.
You are still thinking about it. Chika, you are still thinking about it.
Babe, your husband is not happy. I hope you know that. Especially after all the stress he has been through. You know, I'll figure it out with him.
You're sure?
I will come around. Don't worry.
Thank you.
I'll come around. Honey.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know that Angie's sister just put to bed?
Angie's sister? The one that got married a year ago?
Mm-hmm.
How could she have given birth? Was she pregnant?
I think she was pregnant during their marriage preparations.
What gender did she give birth to?
A boy.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
I need to go get some water to drink.
The days I had the most, trying to conquer the fear. Can't believe the past 2 days. Oh,
who was that?
The day I had the most,
the therapist.
Feel like I'm ripped away.
What did she say?
I remember it's been over 2 weeks, so she's coming to know if I'm making progress.
And what did you tell her?
I told her I started a week late and then it's gonna take some couple of days to be done.
Everything will be alright. It's okay. I'll be inside. It's just a matter of
time. We're in this together.
Yes.
It's gonna be over. I hope we're on the same page.
Eddie, I need to rest.
Try to conquer the fear. I can't believe I passed through this.
I've been taking it easy on her, but I am tired. I am exhausted, I wouldn't lie.
Have you tried talking to her to know where she stands instead of just jumping to conclusions?
Are you for real? Of course, I called her a couple of times and she won't just give me any response. She'll just walk out and, Eddie, I'm tired. That's it.
Look, I feel you've done your part. Okay, just let her be for now.
Hello, let her be. How can I let her be? Come on, I've been letting her be all the time, but it doesn't work. And look at me with a belly bump because of her.
I understand. Look, all I'm saying is that you've endured up to this point. Okay, just give her some time. Let her be for now. We'll see how it works out.
Listen, I've been a good husband enough for every woman to be proud of and said, this is my husband. I don't want any blames eventually, trust me. I'm telling you guys, I don't want no blames.
I get it, but personally, I still feel you should give her some time.
I feel so sad to go down the lane again. I made up mind, I came to ease again. Oh, everything will be alright. It's just a matter of time. We're in this together. It's gonna be over.
Okay, it's not very urgent at all. Talk to me now, what is it?
I don't know how to say this.
You don't know how to say what? Eh? I'm not going to support any rough decision you take this time around. I will not. I will not support it. Eddie has tried for you. He has made a lot of sacrifices. Why do you keep on punishing him? There's no man on earth that will do what this guy has done for you. Nobody will do it. No man will do it. My husband won't try it. He's made a lot of sacrifices for you. It's high time you reciprocate it. Where's Eddie?
He's inside.
Okay, let me just see him briefly. Coming back.
Oh, come on, that's not advisable. What? Are you for real? No, 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 I can't hang on to this. It's not my life. I need to...
Hi, Eddie.
Hi.
Do you mind if I come inside?
Since you're already here, I'll pull you back.
I hope I'm not disturbing your
place. No, Christopher, since you're already here, I mean, it's okay.
Please, what is really going on?
I don't know. I seriously don't know because for a few days now, my wife has been acting weird.
Did you say anything wrong to her?
No, none that I can think of. The only thing I remember saying to her was, I hope we're on the same page. And she didn't say anything, she just walked out on me. Come on, I'm going to look at what I'm going through because of her.
Eddie, you've tried your best. We've tried our best. Just give me a little time. Let me talk to her.
You just have to talk to her because this is not fair. I'm literally in chains. I'm not living my life.
I know I want her to be pregnant, but she's literally draining everything out of me.
Okay, just give me a moment, okay? Let me go downstairs and talk to her, okay? Why you are behaving this way?
And yet, I don't know where or why this sudden fear has come upon me. I am so afraid.
I don't understand this. I don't. The chica I know is a fighter. You are a survivor. I don't know where this sudden fear is coming from. Why suddenly you're acting like this is not the you that I know. You're a very strong woman. Even though you're a human being, but no, this is not the chica I know. I expected you to fight this by now. I know you can't do this, okay? See, look at me. You can do it. Alright? Say it after me. Say I can do it. Say I can do this.
I can do this.
Say it. Look at me and say it.
I can do this.
Yes, you can do it. Because that is who you are, a fighter. See, I can assure you that by the time this baby enters, you will not even notice. You will have fun with it. It's not as hard as you think. Okay? Look at me.
I've heard you.
I've not seen your car key, but I just want you to know I'm taking this off today.
Oh yes, but you have to wait till 12 noon at least.
But why would I have to wait till 12 p.m.? The time doesn't even matter, does it?
It matters to me, all right? It does. I'm going to the office to see some people who've been waiting for me, so wait.
Seriously, so I'm just going to wait for you to come back?
I won't be long. You have to. I think the keys.
I'm tired.
Baby, what are you doing standing outside?
Baby, I'm tired. I can't wait to take away this thing and just breathe properly.
You will. Can you just relax? You'll take it off. Okay?
Are you sure?
Yes, just.
I must go inside. So the therapist called. Yeah, she did. But I didn't know what to tell her.
You could have just told her that. She's not doing a good job.
Come on, that's not fair. I'm tired. I need to take this off, please.
Baby, you will. Just relax. I'm just coming back. I need to take me a quick nap. When I'm awake, we will have a conversation. Can you take this off?
eat jollof rice. Very spicy. Eddie, I'm talking to you.
Tada, surprise. Surprise, Eddie.
What is it?
Look. We are pregnant.
Please, I'm not fit for your lies or your jokes either, so just...
I am not even joking. Okay, the thing is, I had pregnancy symptoms, so I had to go to the lab
and run a test and be sure before telling you. We're 2 months gone.
Baby, are you serious right now? Oh, finally, come here, look at you, baby. Thank you very much. You don't know how happy I am. Oh, what do you want me to get you? Just tell me anything. I'll buy you, cook for you.
I'll tell you what I want.
Okay, tell me.
I want you to chase everybody out of this world and give it to me.
Okay. That's a small task.
Anything for you? Come here.
Oh, I love you.
I love you.
I love you so very much, baby. I would so spend it. Oh, I love you, baby.
New days ahead the most. Trying to conquer the fear. Can't believe the past 2 days. Oh, today hurts the most. Feel like I'm ripped away. Cause nobody feel the pains of being true. I feel so scared to go down the lane again.